name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, as we all have gathered here to celebrate the mystery of Christ's love, let us prepare ourselves, acknowledging our failures, limitations, and our weakness, and asking the Lord forgiveness, peace, and strength. Lord Jesus, you are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you came to call the sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels, who were given power to damage the land and the sea, "Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God." I heard the number of those who have been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. For everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see the God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, these days we will be having three important celebrations that could help us reflect more about the mortality and the sacredness of our God-given life. They are Halloween, All Saints' Day, and All Souls' Day. For Halloween celebration, besides our trick and treat, we decorate our homes with the beautiful carved and uncarved pumpkins. Some of us wear the jacket with the picture of pumpkins. I used to go for a walk up in the Miller Road, and I could see many houses decorated with pumpkins, carved and uncarved. Whenever I see those pumpkins, it comes to my mind a story that my mother told when I was a child. One day, I asked my mom, "What is it like to be a Christian saint?" And my mother told me, "It is like being a Halloween pumpkin. God picks you from the field, brings you in, and washes all the dirt off you. Then he cuts off the top and scoops out the yucky stuff. He removes the pulp of impurity and injustice and seeds of doubts, hate, and greed. Then he carves you a new smiling face and puts his light of holiness inside you to shine for the entire world to see." And this is the Christian idea behind the carved pumpkins during Halloween season. November 1st, we celebrate the solemnity of All Saints. And November 2nd, we celebrate All Souls' Day. And these solemnity of All Saints and All Souls' Day, family reminds us of something that we already know, that death is our destiny from the moment of our birth. Everything will pass away and reach its end. Those who turned their backs on God and refused to repent will end up in hell, and those who are one with God will end up in heaven. If we want to go to heaven someday and become saints, our goal should be to accumulate spiritual goods in this life instead of earthly goods. Those spiritual goods are the ones that we will take with us on our journey from this life to the next. All Saints Day reminds each and every one of us that God's call for holiness is universal. That all of us are called to live in His love and to make His love real in our lives for those around us. Holiness, H-O-L-I-N-E-S-S. Holiness is related to the word of wholesomeness, W-H-O-L-E-S-O-M-E-N-S-S, wholesomeness. We show the holiness when we live the lives of integrity and truth. That is, wholesome and integrated lives in which we are close to others while being close to God. We should remember, however, that to become a saint, we need not do any extraordinary things. Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, who lived in India, says, to be a saint, do ordinary things with great love. We must do well all of those things that we are called upon to do every day. That is exactly what the great saints did. They were human beings just like us. The difference is that they lived life fully, and today they are contemplating the glory of God because they knew how to live their lives with integrity. They had the temptations like us. They had the difficulties and the sicknesses just as we do. They became saints because they knew how to overcome those problems with the patience and prayer, offering to God their suffering, the good and the bad they experienced daily. And they did what they had to do. They had been faithful to Jesus Christ despite all the difficulties of living the Christian life and being a follower of Jesus Christ. That is why they are now given white robes, as in the vision of John that we heard in today's first reading. The saints, whether famous and canonized or unknown and not canonized, are the examples to us, my dear friends. We should imitate them so that after we die, we can reach with them the salvation that God promises us. A question I am sometimes asked is, why do we pray to saints? Why not just pray directly to God? Dear friends, we pray to the saints because they can help us on our journey to Jesus Christ. They are now gathered around the throne of God, and they can intercede for each and every one of us. And we know that they do intercede for us and help us because so many people claim to have received favors through praying to a saint. So praying to the saint is powerful. They are our brothers and sisters from every country and from every generation, and they can help us on our path to God. November 2nd, we celebrate All Souls Day. All Souls Day is a day specially set apart for us to remember and pray for our dear ones who have gone to their eternal reward and who are currently in a state of ongoing purification. From time immemorial, people of all religions have believed in the immortality of the soul and have prayed for the dead. And the greatest act of prayer is to offer Mass for the dead, because in this one sacrifice, the merits of our Lord Jesus Christ are applied to the dead. And let us not forget to pray to our dear departed, have Masses offered for them, visit their graves, and make daily sacrifices for them. Remember, every time you remember someone who has passed from this life and offer a prayer for that person, you are growing with an attitude of gratitude. Fulton Jashin once said that we will have three surprises in heaven. First, there will be many there whom we never expected to be there. Second, there will be many absent whom we expected to see. And third, we will be surprised that we ourselves got in. But the real question is, who will enter God's kingdom? And there is only one answer: those who choose the narrow gate. And they will come from the east and west, and they will eat together, live together, and enjoy God's beatific vision for all eternity. Yes, my dear friends, with faith and hope rooted in Jesus Christ's victory over sin and death, and in the ever-faithful love of God which he reveals, we pray for all the faithful departed so that more quickly they may enter into the church of the blessed in the heaven and from there assist us on our pilgrim way home, especially the month of November. Let us pray often, indeed daily, with a renewed faith and deepened hope. May the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Remember that we are one body in the church that goes beyond the grave. Like the cells in the body, we are united with those in heaven and in purgatory. And may the Mother of God, Queen of Saints and Gate of Heaven, intercede for our journey of holiness and for our dear ones who have preceded us and are now part of the ecclesial homeland. Amen. Now let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The saints in heaven intercede for us with the God who hears every prayer.
Please respond to each petition with the words, Lamb of God, hear our prayer. For the worldwide church, that it will always draw strength and perseverance as exemplified by all the unnamed saints who stayed true to their calling, let us pray to the Lord.
Lamb of God, hear our prayer.
For our nation, that those who are voting will do with their heart and their conscience, let us pray to the Lord.
Lamb of God, hear our prayer.
For all who grieve the loss of a loved one, that they will be blessed with healing and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lamb of God, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick or are near death, and those who care for them, that they know the reality of God's love through the community's support and prayers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lamb of God, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Mary Jane Schaefer and Greg DeRigi, for whom this Mass is offered, that they may now share in the heavenly banquet with Jesus, our Savior, let us pray to the Lord.
Let us also remember all the sick and suffering and those who are taking care of them. And world peace. Let us also pray for all our petitions, needs and desires that we hold in the deep recesses of our heart. We pray to the Lord. Holy immortal God, you preserve your people in time of trial. Hear our prayers, which we join to those of the saints in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by the faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we all acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with the Francis, our Pope, Kevin Sweeney, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Now let us offer each other some sign of peace. Lamb of God, may the mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal salvation to each one of us who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, your breath brought life to the world, by your holy body and blood, praise from all sins of our body. Let us be faithful to your teachings and our people.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins and sins of the world. Blessed and happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
For those watching from home, an act of spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Across
Remember, the youth of Rice will be selling Christmas wreath again this year, and you can pick up an order form in the narthex on your way out. Let us pray. Father, Holy One, we praise your glory reflected in the saints. May we who share at this table be filled with your love and prepare for the joy of your kingdom, where Jesus is the Lord forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Now bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. God is the glory and joy of all his saints, whose memory we celebrate today. May his blessing be with you always. Amen. May the prayers of the saints deliver you from present evil. May their example of holy living turn your thoughts to the service of God and neighbor. Amen. God's Holy Church rejoices that her children are one with the saints in lasting peace. May you come to share with them in all the joys of our Father's house. Amen. And may the blessings of the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always. Now let us go in peace of Christ to proclaim and live the gospel of the Lord. So good evening. It is my wish and prayer that you all have a wonderful week and celebrate the All Saints Day, but don't forget to pray for your departed ones. The whole month of November is dedicated to the All Souls. So visit the graves, pray for them, offer the sacrifices and the masses. So have a blessed and wonderful week.